Welcome to the second video of our channel, Cancer Surgery Masterclass. A few words of surgical wisdom. In this video, we'll be discussing the two most important features a great surgeon should possess and 8 traits that attribute to those two features. The two most important weapons in the armory of a good surgeon are wit and skills. You need both, since they are complementary. Wit is smart and quick decision making. When a patient comes to you, analyze all available data and decide without a delay whether surgery is needed or not. Do not take time for granted. If you have any doubt about your decision, present it to the multidisciplinary team for re-evaluation. We know that multidisciplinary teams or MDTs are not a luxury shared by all the surgeons around the world. If so, talk to a few enthusiastic colleagues in related disciplines and organize one. It only needs your will and persistence. Surgical skill is the next important weapon in your armory. If one has poor hand skills but all the latest technology, then it is similar to having a Ferrari with a bad driver. Remember, hand skills are not necessarily something that you are born with. It is something you can develop through hard work and dedication. The father of vascular surgery, Dr. Alexis Carrel, was a good example. He sought the help of a seamstress in order to develop a technique for vascular anastomosis. In order to achieve wit and skills, we think you must try to develop all or most of these traits. Be a good reader. Be a good leader. Be a good strategist. Be an expert in damage control. Be observant like an eagle. Be brave like a lion. Be tender like a lady. And above all, be responsible. Gather knowledge. There are excellent publications on surgical oncology. For instance, the surgical oncology clinics of North America. Develop the ability to extract feasible data that can be implemented in your setup. It is this knowledge that will help you to develop the wit. Develop the traits of a good team leader, because you need the integrity of the team to perform complex operations with good outcome. Lead from the front. Improve your surgical skills. Get the best out of your juniors and never be judgmental. You will see in this slide that being a surgeon with good surgical skills will invariably contribute to your chances of being a good team leader, because your juniors will be inspired by your skills. So you see, everything is interrelated. Plan before you take the knife. Anticipate the likely problems during surgery and make sure help is available in case of an emergency. Be humble and know the limitations of your skills and the limitations of your hospital setup. German Field Marshal Erwin Rommel once said, "No plan survives contact with the enemy." Tumors are unpredictable. When you reach the tumor during surgery, you are likely to see a totally different tumor mass than the picture you had in your mind. You will not be worried if you have mastered damage control during advanced surgery. While trying to achieve macroscopic tumor clearance, you may accidentally or sometimes deliberately damage surrounding structures. So learn how to repair major vessels, ureters, and bladder injury. Participate in workshops to get familiar with these techniques. When operating in a region that contains vital structures, for example, like the femoral triangle and the carotid triangle, avoid small incisions even when performing minor operations like lymph node biopsy. Good exposure is therefore needed for proper anatomical dissection. Vital structures in these regions must be found and preserved very early in the operation to avoid damage. Be observant like an eagle. During the operation, observe not only the surgical field but also the surroundings. For example, observe the cardiac monitor for arrhythmias while carrying out transsital esophagectomy posterior to the pericardium. Also, do not forget, lack of bleeding in the surgical field may also be due to marked hypotension. Be brave like a lion. A pancreatic tumor invading the portal vein may deter many a surgeon from excising it. But on-block dissection together with the vein may significantly increase the long-term survival of the patient. Smooth tissue handling is essential in achieving excellent outcome during surgery. The best historical example is coarse improvement on Billroth method of thyroidectomy. Using gentle tissue handling alone, he was able to bring down the mortality following thyroidectomy from 40% to 1%. Be responsible. Grow from your mistakes. Be accountable. And make sure you learn something with every complication you encounter. Above all, do no harm. Treat the patient, not the cancer. Do not repeat an excision if you are sure you cannot achieve macroscopically clear margins. Do not attempt reoperation unless you are certain that the patient is going to be benefited from your attempt. Perform palliative surgery only if it is going to improve the quality of life of the patient significantly. Do the maximum from the minimum. Minimum sharpens your skill. Minimum makes you tough. Minimum triggers creativity. Minimum humbles you. World's first heart transplant was not performed with the highest amount of resources. It was made possible by the enthusiasm and the skill of Dr. Christian Bernard. A good pilot knows how to fly. A better pilot knows how to fly and how to survive a crash. The best pilot knows how to fly, how to survive a crash, and above all, how to avoid a crash. We hope these tips and traits will inspire you to be a better surgeon. Please give your ideas and suggestions in the comment section below. I hope you find this presentation helpful. Thank you for watching.